Would you like to build great looking landing pages with no technical ability and do it absolutely for free? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how to build a landing page just like this with Google Sites. This video is sponsored by Pipedrive. Pipedrive is the easy to use CRM that has one key purpose in mind: to help you grow your business and get more sales. Click the link in the description below to try Pipedrive free for 30 days, plus get 20% off your first year. Whether you're inviting someone to buy something from you or to opt into an email list or some other lead magnet, landing pages are so crucial for every business. But that means we need to be able to create them in a matter of minutes, make sure that they load super fast, and hopefully do it at a reasonable price. Well, the great thing about Google Sites is it allows us to do all three of those things. And what I mean by a reasonable price, I mean absolutely free. So here I am within my Google Sites account, and we are going to start with a blank screen. Yes, there's a number of different templates that you could get started with, but I'm going to show you how easy it is to create a great landing page starting with a blank screen. So if we hit that little plus button here, we are going to be given a title screen, but the first thing that I want you to do is come up here over to themes. Now, there's a few different themes for us to choose from. I recommend that you start with impression, because compared to some of the other themes, it's really going to make things jump out and stand out. And let's start right there with our headline. The headline might be the most important thing as a part of your landing page. So in this example, I'm going to be promoting a webinar, so I want to give it something catchy and punchy up front. So my headline is going to read "The One Webinar You Don't Want to Miss," but I don't like the layout. I don't like the text covering three different lines. Well, no problem. All we need to do is just simply drag it to a position that we prefer, and now that's much easier to read. And remember, Google Sites, of course, is responsive, so this is still going to look great even on a small mobile device such as our phone. Now, this red shade here is completely customizable, but let's come back to that in just a moment. Next, we want to add two very important parts to any landing page. One is an image, and two is a subheader along with a brief description as to what it is we are offering or why someone should click that sign up button, that buy now button, whatever it is that you are offering. Now, we could do this one at a time by clicking text box and images, but I think it's much easier and also much faster if we make use of content blocks. So I'm going to select content block, and immediately it's going to bring it below my header, below my banner image here. So I can click on this plus button over the image. I'm going to select upload, and I'm going to select the image that I want. Now, it's going to try and fit the placeholder that was already there, but no problem. We can adjust, we can crop, we can edit this image the way that we want. In my example, all I need to do is stretch the lower part of my image just like this, and now my image is fitted perfectly. Now, on the right-hand side of the screen is where I can add my sub-headline along with some key bullet points. Now, after entering in the information that I want, I'm not very pleased with the size or the layout. Remember, it's using this theme along with its fonts and its sizing. But don't forget, everything here is customizable. So maybe this subheader, I don't want to be the title. I'm going to come down here and select subheading. So now it's not only a lot smaller, but it seems to fit with a better subheading right here as well. I want to make it a little bit bolder though, and maybe let's bump up the size of this. Yes, that looks a lot better for my needs. And then down below, I also want to punch up this "You Will Learn." I'm going to make that a little bolder and punch that up to font size 14. So now I've got something that looks and feels a little bit cleaner. So now we have something that seems to fit the style and the overall feel of this page. Now, of course, the fourth component might be the most important on any landing page, and that is the call to action. Typically, we want to include that in the form of a button, which is going to take them someplace else, or maybe you want to embed something on this screen, such as the sign up to your email list. In this case, we're going to come back up to insert. And if we scroll down, we have all of these other options and features which we can include. I'm going to select the button option and I'm going to say, sign me up now. And then down below, all I need to do is add the link to where people will go when clicking that button. Now, just as with other components of our landing page, we can make edits to that button as well. If we don't want it to span the full width, we could just make it a standard button size. If we don't want it to be filled, and maybe we just want it to be outlined, we can make those changes as well. Personally, I find that the filled option and the full option is the most impactful, but we'll also look the best on various screen sizes. Now, we're almost ready to preview our page and see how it will look, but there's one last component that I would encourage you to include, and that is some social proof. Here down below, it looks like a great space where I could put some reviews or maybe some things that people have said on my social media accounts just to encourage them to sign up for this particular webinar. So once again, we're going to come up to insert, but this time we are going to select images and I'm going to select upload and I'm going to go and grab this piece of social proof. And for this tutorial, I'm simply going to duplicate it two more times and then I'm going to drag it over here. Of course, you wouldn't put the same testimonial three straight times. This is just a placeholder for today's demo. Now, the last thing that you may want to do is either change the color of this page and also enter the name of your business or your website. Sometimes it can be very comforting to let people know that they've landed on something that is specific to your business or your brand. So up here in the corner, maybe I'm going to type in something like simple solutions, or alternatively, I could also add a logo. And then if we're not wild about this red color here, we can go back to our themes and here in the lower right-hand corner, we can choose one of the default colors below, see how that changes the look and feel of the screen, or we can come here and enter in our custom hex code. And don't forget, other elements here are editable as well. If you want to change the image here for the header, you could upload your own or simply give it a solid color. But when you're ready to preview, all you need to do is come up here to the top of the screen, select this little laptop mobile icon, and it will give you a full preview of what your landing page will look at, including the button that we've created down below. And if you want to see what it will look like on a mobile device, you can preview it here as well. When you're all done and ready to publish, come up here and select that publish button. The only thing left to do is to add a web address. So in this case, I'm going to say 7 free web apps, and it looks like that is available. I'm going to select publish, and now I can go ahead and share this link with whomever I want, put it wherever I want, link it to wherever I want, and they will come to my custom landing page. So the next time you want to create a great looking landing page and do it for free, make sure to do it right here within Google Sites. Thank you so much for watching today's video, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.